Welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate, and we are looking at the Wildwood 261BHXL. Some of the cool features about Wildwood is, one, this is a half-ton towable coach. Two, it has power everything, so it makes it really fun and easy to set up to enjoy your camping experience. Two remotes I have here. One is to be able to select to use your power slide out, or your awning, I should say. So you can select whether you want the awning to go in and out. You can turn these lights so that they turn either different colors or one solid color. You can control the electric stabilizer jacks. So all of that from just a couple little remotes. There's also manual overrides for things like this too, if you need them. So yeah, if I were to select, let's see if I can select an awning here and push it out, as you can see, there you go. And I'll show you how far it goes out. It goes out pretty far, so that a lot of people, they'll throw one of those rugs down right here so that you have something to put your campsite chairs on. And that's about the end right there. And yeah, it goes plenty far, so even on a day where the sun's not quite in the right position, you still have lots of shade to work with. Another cool feature, this is a tandem axle, so it's going to pull a little bit better down the road as you're rolling through. It has pass-through storage that you can access from this side, the other side, or even underneath the bed as well. You'll notice how high the diamond plate comes up this, so that you have, if you have some rock chips or something like that hitting on this area, it's not going to beat it up nearly as bad. Two 20-pound propane tanks right here, power tongue jack, as well as a little light that lights up so that you can see what you're doing if you're coming and camping after work and it's getting dark outside. There's a manual override for this as well if you need to. As we walk over here, this is your other access to that pass-through storage that we just talked about. So that's kind of nice. You have both city water, fresh water fill, cable and satellite inlets, spare tire cover, a gas DSI hot water heater that you can just push a button to turn the gas on the inside. Let's go check out some of the features on the inside. Inside the 261BHXL, there's plenty of stuff to show you on the inside. One of the cool things that they just recently upgraded was the stereo in this one. So this has a DVD player, but also has a mic, an SD card, an auxiliary port in, a USB port in. It even has Bluetooth, which is new for this particular model. You can control inside speakers, outside speakers, all from right here. This is what the dinette area looks like. So you can sleep on this area. You can see I got some room to lay down still. And then this folds into a dinette. These are reversible. So if you if it's spaghetti night or something like that, you can not get your cloth dirty. This has a couple poles, that go right here into the floor to lock the table into place. And you'll notice too, there's an outlet right here, which is kind of handy to have as well. So this guy just slides right on like that. You'll notice that they've upgraded to a nice wood blinds as well, instead of like the mini blinds or curtains or something like that in the dining room, where there's a huge window right here to work with. As well as tons of windows. So they have one over the sink area, one by the couch area. So yeah, tons of them. This has also, here's a little pointer that I'd mentioned to you guys. So there's a TV antenna built onto the top of this that you can crank up and down. This is a booster for that antenna. If it's a little green light that lights up, you know that booster is on to get a little bit better reception. Just make sure you turn that off afterwards if you're not using it, so it doesn't drain your battery slowly. It has the nice glass cooktop on here that makes for an excellent backsplash. It has the oven. A lot of them don't come with an oven. Microwave, high-rise sink faucet with the 60-40 split for the for the sink here. Nice metal glide drawers as your, and it already is pre-cut out for your spoons, forks, and knives. And a second drawer right below that, as well as extra pantry. And that would be a good spot for, like, you know, pots and pans and things like that. And then both sides here open up as well for even more storage that you can access either from the side spot, or you can lift the seat cushion off and access it that way. This is a 6 cubic foot Dometic refrigerator that can run off both propane and gas. So it's a little bit fancier than your typical fridge at home because it can run off both. That way, if you're dry camping and you're not plugged in, it'll auto switch over to the gas side so that it keeps your food cool. This one can sleep 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, almost 8, probably 8 to 9 people in this guy, depending on how many kids versus adults. But you'll notice there's a big bunk down below here, as well as a top bunk, and then even more storage here, and an escape window if you need to get out of here in a hurry. And another thing, they've made it so that there's a big sink in here instead of the small sink. So they're doing a lot of upgrades that they didn't necessarily have to. Medicine cabinet, LED lights throughout. So that's gonna run a lot cooler. They're gonna last a lot longer. They're brighter. They don't use nearly the battery consumption that an LED or incandescent light would use. And since they don't run as hot, it won't fight your AC. And again, another huge feature on this guy, this is a ducted air conditioning instead of box AC. So that's gonna spread out the unit to cool it down more evenly. As we finish going into the bathroom area, you'll notice that it not only has a fan, but in addition, it has the skylight. So a lot of campers like this, you'll notice there's no skylight. They have this part right here, but they won't have this part. So yeah, and it's a tub, so if you do have kids that you want needed to take a bath, you can do that. Also, underneath here is extra storage too. Let's see here if I can open this guy up from this side. Oh, it's screwed down right now, but there is extra storage underneath there too if you need. Over here, I wanted to show you a couple things. Does come with the screen door, as well as a spot to kick off all the shoes. So this couch folds into a bed. Let me put this window shade up a little bit. And you'll notice it has the nice armrests on it instead of just the couch. So a lot of them, they don't come with armrests that you can pull out. And then if you turn this into a bed, you'll notice I still have walking room around here too, so it doesn't cut off all the walking room. And then underneath here is that huge amount of storage. So it has storage access from here that you can access from that side, or over here, so that you're not having to go outside to grab your sleeping bag that you threw in there as you stored it or whatever else. And then it has two windows. And again, these are escape windows. So if you needed to get out of here in a hurry, that's an escape window. This is an emergency escape window. This one is as well. So, and then you can open these up. The thing I like about these types of windows is if it's raining outside, you can clip it right there and you can see that the rain can't get in. So it keeps things a little bit drier than the kind that just slide. So tons of features in this guy at a price point that's pretty much unbeatable compared to a lot of other guys out there in a similar size. So thanks for joining me here on this Wildwood 261BHXL. Check us out on our web, thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. Come visit us here at Evans, Colorado. We're about an hour north of Denver, just the southeast part of Greeley. And our phone number is 970-313-4337. Thanks.